Senior Religion, Don Bosco play, really, really a good one, and Take It Away.
It's the year 2024, and the second semester has begun at Archbishop Shaw. Raymond Howard, House Prefect of House Acutis, is preparing for a great finish to his senior year. His House Acutis lost first place to House DeSales in the first semester, and he does not want to end this year with another loss. The loss to St. Thomas More in the state semifinals has made him frustrated and mad. Raymond Howard is obsessed with trying to make Shaw the best Catholic school in the state of Louisiana, and certainly the best Catholic school in the Archdiocese. He wants the spirit of Don Bosco to pervade every aspect of the school. He is a man on a mission, but lately he's been trying too hard and becoming demanding and harsh with just about everyone. He knows Shaw is doing well, but somehow he wants it to return to the glory days. Day after day, he is obsessed with trying to make the school better, but he has let his anger fuel him into becoming a madman. Now he is lashing out at people and barking out orders constantly. Many kids are losing respect for him, and the underclassmen feel like he's bullying them. Let's now go to see what Raymond is up to at Shaw on the day before the Feast of Don Bosco.
Father Steve has built a new chapel. Mr. Russo has organized the household system. Mr. Marchese has restored discipline, and most of the coaches are producing winning teams. Coach Hank and his staff have done a hell of a job with the football team, but it's just not enough. Some of these damn kids don't listen. This school could become great again. Now that's an idea I got from Donald Trump. Make America great again, make Shaw great again. I'm going to do it by golly. If I have to push around these 8th graders and freshmen, I'll force them to make this school great. Look, guys, the Archbishop comes tomorrow, and so does the girls from AOL. Let's not disgrace ourselves. So set these chairs up. Ten chairs to a row. Keep them neat, darn it. You kids don't listen. Not 9, not 11, but 10. 10 in each row. Simple. Got it, stupid?
If it's so simple, why don't you get seniors to do it?
How about I take one of these chairs and pound you across the head with it?
You kids don't have a strong work ethic. The seniors are trying to force you to learn discipline. Listen to George and Kylas.
I'm kind of tired.
Listen, little man, you don't know what tired is. You should have seen me in the Kennedy game. I never gave up when the going got tough. Anchor down. Now get back to work.
Why don't you lead by example? You're supposed to be senior leaders, not supervisors. Pick up some chairs and help, will you?
Enough. If you kids don't want this to be a better Salesian school in the true spirit of Don Bosco, then you need to stop being babies.
We've been working all afternoon. Come on, Raymond, give us a break. Get some seniors over to help.
That's it. You 8th graders know nothing about the true spirit of Don Bosco. You don't want this school to be the best.
Are we done yet?
Nope, you're not finished. The chairs are not straight. I'll see all three of you tomorrow morning at 6 a.m. sharp. You're straightening out these rolls and set up the altar for Father John.
Six? I usually go to bed at 4 a.m. on school nights.
That's why you come to school in the middle of the second block all the time. You're a disgrace to the true spirit of Don Bosco.
Come on, Raymond. Is this treatment you're giving us the true spirit of Don Bosco that you keep preaching about?
Yes, hard work and discipline. If that means that things are not fun, then they are not fun, period. Grow up, you little punks.
Gee, I thought the spirit of Don Bosco was reason, religion, and kindness. There's nothing very reasonable or kind about the way you guys are treating us.
And nothing too religious about it either.
Shut your mouth and be here in the morning or you'll pay for it.
Raymond, I saw the A-Raider leaving. They seem very upset. Do you need anything? I have time before work to help you set up.
No, Tien. I got this. And do me a favor. Just mind your own business.
Sorry, bro. I just want to help.
If I needed your help, I would have asked for it. I'm in charge, not you. So turn around and go back to Vietnam, okay?
Whatever, bro. You're really a terrible leader. That's why Austin better than you.
Scat, go. Get lost, little boy. I just don't see what this school is going to do without me. These kids gotta grow up and stop being little babies.
We might have to use a little old-fashioned discipline.
I'm saying, yes indeedy.
That night, Raymond went to bed with a heavy heart. He really was a good guy, but each day, he became more misguided and confused. Before going to sleep, he said his prayers.
Dear Lord, I only want the best for Shaw. Somehow, make this school great. Don Bosco's spirit must be alive here. I just don't know how to do it. I guess I'll have to simply be harder on people. Go away. Get out of my room. Who are you? Get out of here.
Raymond, I've come to take you on a trip.
Am I dreaming? I got school tomorrow, and it's a special day. It's the feast of Don Bosco. I can't go anywhere.
You are coming for me, Raymond, for it is my feast day that you are celebrating.
Wait, you're Don Bosco? Are you really here with me? Tell me. I demand to know who you are.
I am Don Bosco, and I've come to take you on a little trip into the past.
But, let me change into my school uniform first. I've got to get ready for school soon. I can't.
Raymond, you will come with me now. Let's go, and pay attention, young man, and learn something about the way a true Salesian school should be.
Where are we?
The year is 1854, and we are at the Oratory in Turin, Italy. There are some of our student leaders at the Oratory.
Oh my, is that Dominique Savio over there in a green suit?
Yes, that's him. The student leaders are having a meeting about the celebration we are having, and Dominic is in charge. Now, listen to the way he does things and learn something.
Don Bosco wants everything to be done well for the visit of the Archbishop of Turin, Bishop Franzoni. He will be here tomorrow to celebrate the Feast of Saint Aloysius.
Very good. Dominic, do you think we will have enough time to get ready for this?
If we all pull together and practice Don Bosco's way, we will be fine. But no arguing.
Okay. Dominic, I'll take care of making sure the church is clean and that all the stuff for the sacristy is set up perfectly.
Excellent. We need a lot more planning than just cleaning up the church. We've all got to represent ourselves well.
Perhaps we should keep it simple, a simple mass, and present the bishop with a basket of fruit?
Wrong answer, Jacob. We got to go big. If we pull all our talents together, we can have a festive celebration, the like of which Turin, Italy has never seen. Rua, where's your checklist?
Music?
I got that. We will have a choir practice this afternoon.
The actual mass itself?
I will train and practice with the servers and readers.
That's the spirit.
Drama. We need a humorous skit to make the bishop laugh.
We'll do a skit about the life of St. Aloysius, and I'll throw in some comedy. Joseph, you're pretty smart. Help me write the skit.
Invitations?
Don Bosco wants all the clergy of Turin invited and all the politicians. Let them know that the church is alive and well in those troubling times. Rua, you better handle that one yourself. What else?
Food, snacks, and desserts?
I'll handle that.
Yes, you handle it. Xavier, can you take up a collection and help get it paid for too? This is our oratory. We all have a responsibility to make it great. Thank you, Xavier. I really appreciate this.
Clean up afterwards?
I'll stay after and clean up.
Yes, I promise I'll get at least 20 kids to be with us for cleanup. Ethan, we won't leave you hanging.
Very good, very good. All will be well. Guys, I can't thank you enough for your generosity. If we pull out all our resources together, we will have a tremendous feast. Let's entrust the whole project to the Blessed Mother. Hail Mary, full of grace.
Blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
What Raymond witnessed was good leadership by Dominic Savio. He praised and thanked everyone. He prayed with them and got everyone taking full responsibility for the success of the oratory. Don Bosco knew that if all the boys and teachers would generously work together, the oratory would produce great young men for society and for the church. Don Bosco had the vision, but he had passed it on to Savio and the others who were able to energize the entire community.
Leadership is never easy, Raymond. You're trying, but you got to change your style and attitude. I brought you here to show you the way Savio and the early boys of the oratory were leading their peers. I hope you learned something.
Listen, Don Bosco, nowadays, these kids from the West Bank aren't as good as the ones in Italy in the old days. I need to push them with a firm hand to do stuff.
Raymond. The key of the system of education is kindness. Please think about what you saw before it's too late. I warn you. You need to change.
This is all probably a dream anyway. Dominique Savio would never succeed with today's kids unless he used force. I just want to make Shaw great again. Can I get back to my bed now?
Go back to bed. But no, I'll be back when the clock strikes two.
Oh, thank God. Imagine Don Bosco taking me back into the oratory. It was just a stupid dream. I'm perfectly all right, and the way I act as a leader is best for the situation here at Shaw. Period. Amen. Good night again, Lord. I need sleep.
Raymond Howard, get up. Let's go.
Not again. When will this nightmare end? Who are you? No, let me guess. The ghost of Don Bosco.
I'm the ghost of Don Bosco present. We are going to visit a situation at school today that you are not aware of.
Leave me alone. I want to go back to sleep.
There'll be no sleep for you until you see the pain and inconvenience that you've caused others. Look at the way those three have to spend their day tomorrow morning.
I got the 5 a.m. city bus this morning. That darn Raymond, he's not even here. Neither is George or Kylos.
My mother worked a night shift at the hospital and picked me right up from home so I could be here by 6. What are we supposed to do?
I'm gonna sleep over on the bleachers.
These kids are whiners. They need this treatment. That's the only way they're going to learn discipline. That's the way I learned it.
Don't you think those boys have enough pressures and problems? They don't need to be here in a gym at 6 a.m. with nobody to accompany them.
That's ridiculous. What problems could they have?
Lots. Just listen.
How was Christmas vacation, bro?
My mother just worked at the hospital, and I stayed home the whole time watching my sister.
Even on Christmas Day?
She takes as many shifts as she can to pay the bills.
For real? Sorry to hear that. At least you're still talking to your parents. Mine threw me out of the house.
Where are you staying?
With friends mostly.
You see, Raymond, these kids don't have it so easy.
I never knew they had such problems. Maybe I should have asked them. Well, I can't just be a wimpy leader. It's hard to be the house prefect of Acutis and a leader of the school. Don't you understand? Don Bosco, people are counting on me.
You must know your classmates and your underclassmen, not just order them around.
Okay, I didn't realize.
We must go. Let me show you one more scene that in the present that you were not aware of.
Where are we?
We are at the Vietnamese restaurant.
Hey, that's Tien. He's in my class. What is he doing here so late? What time is it?
It's tonight. Raymond, we are in the present. It's 3 o'clock in the morning, the night before the feast day.
But that's too late for him to be working on a school night. Who's that other dude?
That's the owner of the restaurant. Keep quiet, listen, and learn something.
That party for Coach Lou Vowden went very late. My oh my, they ate lots of food.
And those guys drank 6 cases of beer.
Tien, I have to go now. Must get my beauty sleep. Lock up and make sure everything is perfect for tomorrow.
Okay, boss. I will lock up after I finish cleaning all the pots and pans, and I wipe down all the table in the restaurant.
Good man. I give you extra $5 in your paycheck.
Why does Tien have to work so hard?
You know very well his parents are in Vietnam and he has to pay for his education at Shaw.
I guess I should have been kinder to him. I never realized.
You better start realizing before it's too late. You're being nasty to people.
I'll be darned if that dream didn't seem so real. Dear Lord, 2 crazy dreams in one night? It must have been that pizza I ate. Let me get back to sleep.
Thank you.
Oh no, not again. Let me guess, Don Bosco, we're going into the future.
Get ready, son. You may not like this trip. It's gonna be harder on you than all the others.
I hope you will be showing me a bright future and an excellent career and family. Oh please, please, I dread to see anything but success. Where are we now?
At the Air Force Academy in Colorado Springs. You just completed your first year at the Academy.
That's the head coach. I'm sure he's proud of the effort I put in. I wonder if I'll be a starter in my second year.
Raymond, beware. You're not going to like what he is saying.
Mrs. Howard, this is Coach Wilson from the Air Force Academy in Colorado Springs. Ma'am, I'm sorry to inform you, but I'm kicking Raymond off the team. Ma'am, I'm sorry to disappoint, but Raymond will simply not listen to any other coaches. He keeps telling us that we don't know what we're doing. Yes. Yes, ma'am. I know that deep down he is a good kid, but he's simply out of control. He's been going into a rage with his teammates in the locker room as well. Listen, lady, my decision is final. We're sending him home. His scholarship has been officially revoked.
Oh no, it can't be. That was my ticket to the NFL. This can't be true. Please, Don Bosco. No, please fix things up for me.
Unfortunately, Raymond, the situation in your future gets worse.
May God have mercy on his soul, and I bless you, Raymond Howard, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. May you finally receive the peace you never had in this lifetime.
Thanks, Father Steve. It was good seeing you, even if it was under these conditions.
God bless you, Punch, and you too, Kylas. Hey, it was good of both of you to come. But you're the only two guys from Shaw who came to his funeral? So sad. I'm surprised George Sauter didn't make it.
Sorry, Father. He's in a drug rehab, but should be getting out soon. I'll give him your best.
Okay. Take care, men. Be good, and God bless you guys.
Poor guy. He really lost it the last few years.
I felt sorry for him. After he got kicked out the Air Force Academy, he just went to a deep depression and never got out of it.
Last month, his blood pressure skyrocketed, and the doctor told him he'd have a heart attack if he didn't calm it down.
Such a shame. He wouldn't listen to anyone.
He could have been great, on the field and off the field. He was a natural leader. Then he went wacko. It all started senior year when he became a dictator.
I remember that. It was a feast of Don Bosco when he really went crazy. Poor guy. He ruined his life.
Wait a minute. One more guy from my class is coming. That's Patrick, isn't it? I didn't know he and Raymond were close.
Patrick, you came to Raymond's funeral?
No, I actually just work here now. I was just coming by to fill in the dirt on his grave.
Oh, I see. Patrick, by the way, this is a perfect job for you.
Oh no, I can't bear to see this. Why? Why was my life ruined? Please, Don Bosco, give me a second chance. I'll do right this time. I'll stop being a jerk. I'll control my temper.
Well, let's see. Go back to bed.
Things right. Second chance to make things right. Oh, please, dear God, just give me a second chance to make things right. Hey, Loyola, where are you going?
To school. Hurry, the bell rings in 20 minutes.
What day is it?
It's the Feast of Don Bosco. Hurry up, the Mass with the Bishop begins in an hour.
It wasn't just a bad dream. It was a vision from Don Bosco to straighten me out. And I will change. From now on, I'm going to be a new man, a better leader. I messed up, but from now on, reason, religion, and kindness. No more Mr. Mean Guy. Let me get going.
For the rest of the day, and for the rest of the year, for a matter of fact, everyone in the Shaw community all observed that Raymond was the nicest and friendliest leader a school could ever ask for. He changed his ways completely and became a great leader. He apologized to the 8th graders.
Here, guys. Here's some gift certificates to Outback. Go get yourselves a steak on me.
He made amends with all the upperclassmen he offended also.
Tien, what's up, my brother?
Who, me? Little boy?
I was so wrong in saying that. Can you ever forgive me? I'm never going to say stuff like that again. Can you ever forgive me?
It's okay, Raymond. I believe that you're a really good guy. Just control your temper.
Oh, I will. I promise you that. And after I make it to the NFL, I'm going to start a scholarship for foreign exchange students like yourself. And I'm serious.
God bless us, everyone.
Raymond also corrected and guided his two thuggish friends, Kylus and George, and straightened them out before they continued on the wrong path.
Kylus, George, come over here.
What up, Raymond?
George, you gotta go easy and stop being a wild man. If you keep acting stupid, you're gonna end up on drugs and having to go to a rehab in a year from now.
Man, come on, don't preach to me. I'm not that bad.
We're going to start working out again, and I'm picking you up every Saturday morning, and we're going fishing. From now on, we're going to do good activities together, like Don Bosco will want us to.
You gotta let me come.
Kylus, my brother, you and I are going to be friends for life. We're both going to live the true Don Bosco spirit, and our kids are going to be going to school here in 25 years. I'm sure of it.
Raymond was better than his word. He followed through on all the kind deeds he began to do for others. He became a good friend, as good a leader, and as good as a man than anyone at Shaw had ever known.
Thank you for watching our play, and now we'd like to introduce our cast. On the props and set, Hunter, Vernon, and George Bourgeois. On the sound, Chase and... On the spotlight in the back, Rico. On the smoke machine, Andrew. The eighth graders, Mason, Isaac, and Nugget. As Savio, Aiden. Logan, playing himself. Xavier, playing himself. Scheffler, playing himself. Jack as Rua. Loyola playing himself. Armstrong playing himself. Tien playing himself. Ethan Lee as the boss. Braden Cortez as coach of the Air Force. Punch playing himself. Patrick as the gravedigger. Giving us the moral of the story, Connor. Kylus.